الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه والفائزين برضا الله أما بعد ഏറ്റവും ബഹുമാനാദരവും നിറഞ്ഞ ഗുരുവര്യരെ, എന്റെ ശബ്ദം ശ്രവിക്കുന്ന ശ്രോതാക്കളെ, അസ്സലാമു അലൈക്കും വറഹ്മത്തുള്ളാഹി തആല വബറകാത്തു. ഉമ്മയുടെ ഗർഭപാത്രത്തിൽ നിന്നും ഭൂമിയുടെ പ്രവിശാലതയിലേക്ക് പിറന്നു വീഴുന്ന ഓരോ കുഞ്ഞും സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യനാണ്. എന്നാൽ സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യമെന്ന മൂന്നക്ഷരത്തിന്റെ അർത്ഥം മനസ്സിലാക്കാതെ സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യത്തിന്റെ അതിർവരം മുകൾ ലംഘിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ആഭാസങ്ങൾ അറിഞ്ഞു തകർക്കുന്ന ഈ സംഗീത സാഹചര്യത്തിൽ കടന്നു കയറ്റമല്ല സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം എന്ന വിഷയത്തിൽ അധിഷ്ഠിതമായ എന്റെ വാക്കുകൾക്ക് ഏറെ പ്രസക്തിയുണ്ടെന്ന് ഞാൻ വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു. 30 ലക്ഷത്തോളം ചതുരശ്ര കിലോമീറ്റർ വിസ്തീർണമുള്ള അറേബ്യൻ റിപ്പബ്ലിക്കിന്റെ അജയനായ രണ്ടാമത്തെ പ്രസിഡന്റ് ഉമർ ബിൻ ഖത്താബ് റളിയല്ലാഹു അൻഹു അവിടുത്തെ മഹിളാരത്നങ്ങളോട് നിങ്ങളുടെ മകരിൽ നിന്നും അല്പം കുറവ് കാണിക്കണേ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ ഞങ്ങളുടെ മകരിന്റെ കാര്യത്തിൽ കൈകടത്താൻ താങ്കൾക്കുണ്ട് അധികാരമെന്ന് തിരിച്ചു ചോദിച്ച സ്ത്രീകൾക്കുമേൽ നടപടിയെടുക്കാതിരിക്കാൻ കാരണം താനൊരു ഭരണാധികാരിയായിരുന്നിട്ട് പോലും സ്ത്രീകളുടെ അവകാശത്തിന് മേൽ കടന്നു കയറ്റം നടത്താനുള്ള സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം അത് തനിക്കില്ല എന്ന് തിരിച്ചറിഞ്ഞതുകൊണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അല്ലാഹുവിന്റെ ഖുർആൻ തന്നെ പറയുന്നു, لا يجرمنكم شنآن قوم على ألا تعدلوا اعدلوا هو أقرب للتقوى. ഒരു സമൂഹത്തോടുള്ള അടങ്ങാത്ത വിദ്വേഷം അവരോട് അന്യായം പ്രവർത്തിക്കാൻ നിങ്ങളെ പ്രേരിപ്പിക്കാതിരിക്കട്ടെ എന്ന പരിശുദ്ധ ഖുർആനിന്റെ വചനം മനസ്സിൽ പണിഞ്ഞതുകൊണ്ടാണ് പരിശുദ്ധ ഇസ്ലാമിന്റെ ഇജ്ജത്തുയർത്തി പിടിക്കാൻ വേണ്ടി അതർക്കളത്തിലേക്ക് ശത്രുവിന്റെ ശിരസ്സൊറുക്കാൻ പാഞ്ഞെടുക്കുന്ന സഹാബാ വൃന്ദങ്ങളോട് അല്ലാഹുവിന്റെ പ്രവാചകൻ പറഞ്ഞു കൊടുത്തത്, നിങ്ങൾ അവരുടെ വൃദ്ധജനങ്ങളെ ആക്രമിക്കരുത്, അവരുടെ സ്ത്രീകളെയും കുട്ടികളെയും നിങ്ങൾ ആക്രമിക്കരുത്, അവരുടെ മരങ്ങളും കൃഷിസ്ഥാനങ്ങളും നിങ്ങൾ നശിപ്പിക്കരുത് എന്ന് ഘോരം ഘോരമായി നടക്കുന്ന യുദ്ധത്തിനിടയിലും തന്റെ സഹാബാക്കൾക്ക് നിർദ്ദേശം കൊടുത്തത് സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യത്തിന്റെ അചരപരമുകൾ ലംഘിക്കപ്പെടാതിരിക്കാൻ വേണ്ടിയായിരുന്നു. സഹോദരെ, സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യമെന്നാൽ അതൊരു കടന്നുകയറ്റമല്ല, മറ്റൊരുത്തന്റെ അവകാശങ്ങൾക്കും ആചാരങ്ങൾക്കും വ്രണപ്പെടുത്തലഴിച്ച് മറ്റൊരുത്തന്റെ അവകാശങ്ങൾക്കും ആചാരങ്ങൾക്കും യാതൊരു പോറലേൽപ്പിക്കാതെ പൂർണ്ണ സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യത്തോടെ ഈ ഭൂമിയിൽ ജീവിക്കാൻ ഓരോ മനുഷ്യനും അവകാശമുണ്ട്. ഇത് കേവലം ഒരു രാജ്യത്തിന്റെ നിയമം മാത്രമല്ല, ഈ ഭൂമി ലോകത്ത് വസിച്ചു കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്ന ജനകോടി സഞ്ചയങ്ങളുടെ നിയമമാണ്. എന്നാൽ ഇസ്ലാമിക മാന്യങ്ങളത്രയും ഹൃദയത്തിൽ പേര് ജീവിക്കുന്ന ഫലസ്തീനിന്റെ മണ്ണിൽ ഇസ്രായേൽ മരണാരാക്കി നടത്തുമ്പോൾ തന്റെ വീടിന് നേരേക്ക് പാഞ്ഞു വരുന്ന ടാങ്കിനെതിരെ കയ്യിൽ കിട്ടിയ കരിന്റെ ചുവല്ലെടുത്ത് പ്രതിരോധിക്കുന്ന ബാലനെ വേട്ടനായകൾക്ക് ഭക്ഷണമായി എറിഞ്ഞു കൊടുത്തിട്ട് ആ പിഞ്ചു ശരീരത്തിൽ നിന്നും മാംസഭാഗങ്ങൾ കളിച്ചു മരിക്കുന്ന രംഗങ്ങൾ ക്യാമറക്കല്ലുകളിൽ പകർത്തിയെടുത്ത് അതേ കുഞ്ഞിന്റെ മാതാവിൽ തന്നെ കാണിച്ചു കൊടുത്തുകൊണ്ട് കൂടുതലുടെ ഏറ്റവും വലിയ പര്യായമായി മാറിയ ഇസ്രായേൽ അവന് ചുറ്റും ചങ്ങലക്കെട്ടുകളാണ്. സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യത്തിന്റെ അതിർവരമ്പുകൾ ലംഘിക്കപ്പെടാതിരിക്കാൻ മനുഷ്യജീവിതത്തിൽ ചങ്ങലക്കെട്ടുകൾ അത്യാവശ്യമാണ്. തൊട്ടടുത്തിരിക്കുന്നവന്റെ മൂക്കിൽ തുമ്പവരെ സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യമുള്ള നമുക്ക് അതിനപ്പുറത്തേക്ക് സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യമില്ല. സഹോദരങ്ങളെ, ലോകത്താകമാനയും വിപ്ലവങ്ങൾ നടന്നിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ അതെല്ലാം മനുഷ്യന് സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യത്തിന് വേണ്ടിയായിരുന്നു. വെളുക്ക വർഗക്കാരന്റെ കോട്ടിൻ കുഴലിന് മുന്നിലൂടെ വിരിമാരെ കാണിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് സമരജ്വാലയുമായി മലബാറിന്റെ മണ്ണിലൂടെ മലബാറിന്റെ മക്കൾ നടന്നു നീങ്ങിയത് സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യത്തിന് വേണ്ടിയായിരുന്നു. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം ഹനിക്കപ്പെടുന്നതിന് സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യം നേടിക്കൊടുക്കാൻ, സ്വാതന്ത്ര്യത്തിന്റെ അതിർവരമ്പുകൾ ലംഘിക്കുന്നവർക്കെതിരെ നടപടിയെടുക്കാൻ ഏകനായ റബ്ബുൽ ഇസ്സത്ത് നമുക്കേവർക്കും തൗഫീഖ് നൽകട്ടെ എന്ന ആത്മാർത്ഥമായ പ്രാർത്ഥനയോടെ ഞാൻ എന്റെ ചെറു ഭാഷണത്തിന് വിരാമം കൊടുക്കുന്നു. അസ്സലാമു അലൈക്കും വറഹ്മത്തുള്ളാഹി തആല വബറകാത്തു.
ഇതോടുകൂടി ആ ലോകത്തിലെ മലയാള പ്രസംഗ മത്സരം ഇവിടെ അവസാനിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു. അടുത്തതായി ഉപയോഗം നടക്കാനിരിക്കുന്നത് ഉലാ വിഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് പ്രസംഗ മത്സരമാണ്. പങ്കെടുക്കുന്ന വിദ്യാർത്ഥികൾ എത്രയുമാകാം സജ്ജരായിരിക്കണമെന്ന് അറിയിക്കുന്നു. സോഫ്റ്റ്വെയർ പബ്ലിഷ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഉലാ വിഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഓഫ് സ്റ്റേജ് മത്സര ഫലങ്ങൾ 8:30 സ്കോർ ബോർഡിൽ രേഖപ്പെടുത്തുന്നതാണെന്ന് അറിയിക്കുന്നു. നടക്കാനിരിക്കുന്ന ഉലാ വിഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് പ്രസംഗ മത്സരം വിധി നിർണ്ണയിക്കുന്നത് മുഹമ്മദ് അലി സർ ഇരിങ്ങാട്രി, മുഹമ്മദ് അലി സർ മമ്പുറം, നൌഫൽ സർ എവരെയും ജൂറിപീഠത്തിലേക്ക് സാദരം ക്ഷണിക്കുന്നു.
Towards the synthesis of knowledge, exploring talents, excellence, and the beauty of arts, 8th stage Wafi Wafiya Arts Fest, the greatest Islamic arts fest of India in its kind, is in its last day. Above 4,000 students of 46 colleges in 172 events competing their way to glory. Welcome all with open arms.
بسم الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المخلوقين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. Respected teachers, I'm a beloved students. Here in this colorful context, it is my privilege to draw your kind attention to a most contemporary topic, Islam as Family Guide. Before I come to talk about the topic, let me recite the sacred verse of Holy Quran, قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِكُمْ نَارًا, save yourselves and your families from the fire. Jews, one's life goes incomplete if he has been responsible towards his family affairs, because the family system deserves special consideration in Islam. The family, the basic unit of civilization, is now disintegrating to decline. The family system of Islam brings the rights of the husband, wife, children, and relatives into a fine equilibrium. It nourishes unselfish behavior, generosity, and love in the framework of family system. Father, mother, children, all of them have to work in order to build a perfect family. If any one of them fail, the whole family will be collapsed. Jews, Islam significantly considers the natural family from A to Z, as the prophetic word indicates, Al-mar'atu ra'iyatun fi bayti zawjiha wa mas'ulatun 'an ra'iyatiha. Woman stands at the basement of the family, since she is liable and obliged in terms of both wife and mother, and she has al-jannatu tahta aqdam al-ummahat. Mother occupies the position above the paradise. And again, Islam introduces the wives as close to the husbands, and she has the rights to be treated very well, like the Holy Verse proclaims, wa'ashiruhunna bil ma'ruf. Friends, As far as the father is concerned, he is highly responsible to make the children purified of dirty behavior and misdeeds. Prophet, peace be upon him, orders all the fathers to plant the seeds of prayer behavior inside the children. As he says, لَأَنْ يُؤَدِّبَ الرَّجُلُ وَلَدَهُ خَيْرُ اللَّهِ مِنْ أَنْ يَتَصَدَّقَ بِالسَّهَا. A father in Islam must provide the essential food and discipline towards his family. Otherwise, his religious life is to be placeful one. It is crystal clear, Islam looks at the children through the eye of equality. That is why Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, وَعْدِلُوا فِي أَوْلَادِكُمْ. Moreover, girls get peculiar significance in Islamic family system because Prophet, peace be upon him, promises the paradise to those who looked after two girls until their adulthood. According to the Holy Quran, parents must be cared and cherished during their similarity all these times. It is not absurd, irritating words or child them, as the Almighty denoted, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا. So, followers of Islam never fail to build the perfect family, because Islam regards every characteristic factors of family. Anyone, whether parents or children, either youngsters or elders, cannot be treated in this manner. Like that, Islam orders its believers to maintain the relationship among the family members, respective of distance and years one. وَالَّذِينَ يَسُولُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُسْوَلْ. This means, Quran describes about those who keep relationship unbroken are to be rewarded. Here, I would like to proclaim before this gathering, before this ulama, unlike Christianity and Hinduism, Islam is a matchless family kind. But majority of the people remain another of the principles of Islamic family system. Therefore, we, the propagators of each society, must try our best to introduce the Islam as a real family guide. May Allah bless us to accomplish our destination. Ameen. I can go here. Wa akhu da'wati alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Ula ibadatul English person Amal Saram Tudurana. Next, test number 2303. Just please note 2303 on the stage.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. All praises to Allah, the Lord of entire universe. Peace be upon Prophet Muhammad and upon his family and companions. Respected personalities present here and my beloved friends. I'm in some rapturous state of mind now. Chance to address you, and in particular, as the topic I have to speak on is Islam and feminism. Let us remember the poignant act of Khadija radhiyallahu anha, the first believer in the message of Prophet, when she gave shelter her husband in her blankets from his frightening experience of the cave Hira. In our epic Mahabharata, there is a curse affected God Krishna by the mighty mother Gandhari. In literature, if there was not the blind face of Beatrice, there would not be made the Dante's Divine Comedy. Yes, dears, women were engraving their names as loving mothers and caring wives with God and letters throughout the history. Islam not only perpetuated a society, but alas, feminism proposed a society which makes no social or cultural distinction between the sexes, a society without home, marriage and family, where modesty, chastity and motherhood are scorned. Although Islam and feminism are not complete the common ground, but the principles of Islam and feminism are contrary. Both insist on financial security, both condemn the oppression of women. The dazzling verse of the Quran speaks aloud, I never fail to reward any worker among you for the work you do, be you male or female, you are equal to one other. Yes, dears, this natural religion gives her the key of home. According to Quran, home is the microcosm ummah, the world community, worship is the queen, and in a sense, man is a guest. But the role of woman in Islam by no means limited this. There may be scholars like Aisha radhiyallahu anha, where the half of the Islam came. They may also take strong political stand which led to martyrdom, as did this Fatima radhiyallahu anha. And also the God directly addressed a woman by offering examples such as Maryam radhiyallahu anha and Asiya radhiyallahu anha, who have courageously taken position in unfavorable social condition. Although Islam and feminism are not completely the common ground, but the principles of Islam and feminism are contrary. For the question, how can we recognize the coming of daylight? The discipline answered by telling about different images, but this was the master's response. If a man is unable to see his sister in every woman he faces, it is dark midnight, even the sun is glittering at its fullest. Yes, dears, it is not feminism, but our brotherly care should give her peace and tranquility. Therefore, the Prophet, peace be upon him, proclaimed in last speaking, "O people, fear Allah regarding women, for you have taken trust from Allah." By giving this humble message, I conclude my words. Wa ahdawana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
ഒലായ ഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് പ്രസംഗ മത്സരം തുടരുന്നു. നെക്സ്റ്റ് ഡിസംബർ 1508. This is please note 1508 on the stage. ഒലായ ഭാഗത്തിന്റെ പ്രസന്റേഷനെ ഇന്റർവ്യൂവിനെ റിപ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്യപ്പെടാത്ത മത്സരാർത്ഥികൾ ഉടൻ തന്നെ റിപ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്യണമെന്ന് അറിയിക്കുന്നു.
അസ്സലാമു അലൈക്കും വറഹ്മത്തുള്ളാഹി വബറകാതുഹു. അൽഹംദുലില്ലാഹി കഫ വസ്സലാത്തു വസ്സലാം അലാ റസൂലിഹിൽ മുസ്തഫ വഅലാ ആലിഹി അഹ്ലി സിദ്ഖി വൽ വഫ റബ്ബി ഇശ്റഹ്ലി സദ്രി വയസ്സിർലി അംരി വഹ്ലുൽ ഉഖ്ദത മിൻ ലിസാനി യഫ്ഖഹു ഖൗലി. Distinguished personalities, vulnerable tutors on the dais and of the dais. Addressing a jamboree like this, I feel folds of elation, bubbles of evasion in my heart. Sailing on this fantastic and auspicious occasion, I intend to dispose a concise discourse on my views on a great topic, Islamization of knowledge. First of all, I praise Almighty Allah, who showered on me unmitigated bounties to analyze this topic. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. Friends, a person approached Rabindranath Tagore with the picture that he has drawn when Tagore was in the inaugural function of Shantiniketan, his biggest educational dream. By gazing more time to the picture, Tagore said, "This picture is incomplete. There are birds, flowers, trees and streams, but there is no man. Just like the present education system, all are there, but no man. Nothing for the sake of the human goodness." Dear friends, the name Islamization of Knowledge is coined by Dr. Ismail Razi Al-Farooqi. It's not a fiction, but the remembrance of the realization of a wonderful dream. There have been a number of misconceptions about knowledge. How can we endorse the concept that knowledge is valid only if it was from Isaac Newton, Albert Einstein, or any other specified man? Really, knowledge is the light of the God. So knowledge became valuable when we grasp the divine light. Angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admired Adam alayhi salam because of the powerful light. The lives of innumerable prophets, peace and blessing be upon them, would be an explicit example for the power of knowledge in making a man a real human being. It is the same light that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam received during his event meditation in Hira Cave that made the Mecca the dream garden of spiritual and material knowledge. But friends, badly we need an introspection. Could we be able to particularize the knowledge that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam declared to us? Scrutinizing the present educational system, automatically you will convince it to be brush aside the present curriculum. So, and it's incapable of teaching who is mother, who is father, and what is the value of morality. That's why we are witnessing the educated and ignorant person as same in the name of heroic crimes. Friends, at last but least, we have to say no to the knowledge which is not based on the morality. تَعَلَّمْ مِنْ أَدْبِهِ قَبْلَ إِلْمِهِ. Before the knowledge, we need to study the manners. Yes, regarding the lost entity of present educational system is indispensable. Indeed, modern education needs changes. To depend upon the changes, we need to depend upon a way approach in morality. Sorry, not for my preparation. I conclude my words. Wa akhir da'wan alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
ഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് പ്രസംഗ മത്സരം തുടരുന്നു. നെക്സ്റ്റ് ഡിസംബർ 116, ജഡ്ജസ് പ്ലീസ് നോട്ട് നമ്പർ 16 ഓൺ ദി സ്റ്റേജ്.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Praise be to Allah, Lord of Ages. Peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad, the truthful, and upon his family and companions. Respected personalities of this humble gathering and my beloved brothers, extremely glad I am to win such a golden opportunity to address you, and in special the topic of my talk today is sports in Islam. Before taking you into the depth of the topic, let me be with you by sharing some commendable thoughts. What does Islam say about sports and exercise? Does this ideology put forward any rules and regulations concerning them? And have you ever paid your attention over all these questions? Dears, the term involving the fitness of a person. And it is widely recognized that nobody can avoid sports irrespective of age or place. So friends, coming to Islam, rather than a mere ideology, it is a practiced way of living. It was on this basis Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, conducted a running race with his beloved wife Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her. It was on the same basis the Ethiopians were allowed to play in the sacred compound of Masjid Nabawi during the superb rule of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And it was on the same basis as reported Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, competed armed wrestling with the Hukani, the stronger of that era. Yes, brothers, Islam allows anything that is pure and beneficial for humankind. It encourages a Muslim to be strong and to seek the means of strength. That's why Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, commands us, teach your children swimming, archery, and horse riding. Yes, a direct call to practice sports. What is more, the great Islamic scholar Imam Ghazali discourses pointing to importance given by Islamic government to sports. He says, the continuous sticking to educational activities will make any person fed up. So, finding relaxation is really commendable. Adding to this, he says, a student should take his all things as like medicine. So, as far as consider it is a medicine, so he have to use it as rest. What good attentive. Is there any example more abrasive than this poem in the violence of sports? Is there any piece of stories other than this where we stand baffled and amazed? No, never. This were the spectacular effect of sports Allah's religion Islam they bring about. But unfortunately, I can't help criticizing the blind imitations of sports stars. As far as modern youngsters are concerned, I think as it is said in the advertisements, cricket has been their religion and its player has been their god. But according to me, these modern kinds of imitations should be analyzed, should be criticized, and it should be understood upright. Yes, all sports items can be admired by us, but don't cross the strict boundaries of religion. Don't allow to be in the control of Islam. So, what we have to do is, Islam agrees sports at all. No, but almost all religions, Hinduism, Christianity, almost all religions in the world encourage sports use as well. Unless what may be the result of our body, it should be filled with the diseases, disappointments and despairs. So friends, it's high time to make this community and its youth awakened from this stupidism. To teach them the right values and norms of all Islam and to turn back to prophetic doing, science and to the divine lights of Quran. Here, no more to give you as the last note of my talk, other than sports is always good, as long as it conforms to its boundaries. Here, one more thing has to be known. What is that? Islam teaches sports in a good way. But according to this modern world, it came to be a bad thing. What we have to say that here, what we saw in the Kerala is that is not a bad condition of sports. So as a Muslim, all what we have to do is, we have to attain good knowledge, good capacity, good education, then only we could attain a good generation. So what we have to do is, one more thing, that is, we have to use our strength in a good way, as like in sports. May Allah bless us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
വിഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് പ്രസംഗ മത്സരം തുടരുന്നു. നെക്സ്റ്റ് ഡിസംബർ 1918 ബിസിനസ് പ്ലീസ് നോട്ട് 918 ഓൺ ദി സ്റ്റേജ്.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله الفائزين برضا الله. أما بعد, honorable personalities of this dais and my beloved friends, I'm totally overwhelmed with pleasure while I stand here in front of you trying to convey some musings on the topic Muslim as social being, which is quite relevant in this present context. Dears, wait a minute. Isn't Muslim a social being already? Isn't it obvious? Is it something that we have to prove? Isn't it clear enough? All right, let me make a count. How many of you disagree that Muslim is not a social being? How many? No one? Not even a single one? That's weird. Then why do I have to talk about this topic here? My beloved audience, maybe you all agree that Muslim is a social being, but a number of communities, a number of government officials, and a number of the so-called religious and political leaders, they don't treat Muslim as a social being or even as a human being. Now, take the case in Dadra in UP. The case of our Muslim brother, Muhammad Akhlaq. He was a farmer too. A rumor spread in his hometown that he has slaughtered a cow and he and his family have eaten the beef. A group of Hindu extremists gathered around his house. They dragged him out and beat him to death. His family is in critical stage in the hospital.
It has been weeks now, and our beloved Prime Minister hasn't even condemned the tragic incident. Now, you decide who are the human beings here, who are the social beings, and who are the animals. What happened to you politicians, what happened to you ministers, and what happened to you dear custodians of the Constitution to facilitate the basic rights of an Indian, right to freedom, right against exploitation, and right to freedom of religion. It is shameful to admit that you and I talk about Indian secularism, but still Muslims continue to be victim of mass oppression. Gone were the days where the Prime Minister of a nation went busy on meeting technology giants in America and tried to digitalize India. But what I think Indian needs is, instead of digitalizing India, he should have tried to legitimize the freedom of living and practicing one's belief in India. Dears, now who exactly a social being? My dear audience, a human becomes a social being when that person relates him with the society. He treats the society well and he gets the respect back. Now take the case of a Muslim. Who is a Muslim? Isn't he drinking the same water you drink? Isn't he eating the same food you consume? And isn't he breathing the same air you inhale? Please, I'm begging to know what is the difference that doesn't make a Muslim a social being. Is it because he eats beef? Well, Hinduism also allows eating beef, which is mentioned in Manusmriti chapter number 6, verse number 30. Or is it because he believes in Allah and follows his messenger Muhammad? Peace be upon him. Well, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, said, لَيْسَ الْمُؤْمِنُ مَنْ بَعْدَ سِبْرَانَ وَجَارُهُ جَعْيُونَ. A Muslim is not a Muslim if he eats pills while his neighbor is hungry. The neighbor can be a Muslim, Hindu, Christian, or anyone. My dear extremists, it's embarrassing that you still think Muslims are antisocial. How poor is your rational mind and humanity? Brothers, let it be clear, Muslim is a social being as any other individual is. He deserves to be respected as any other person is respected. Terrorism and extremism are not his manifesto. His desire of the well-being of all those around him, including Christians and Hindus, is part of his iman. By this message, I am concluding my words. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
ശ്രദ്ധിക്കുക, മജ്മാൽ വെങ്ങപ്പള്ളി, കെ കെ എസ് എം, വാഫക്കെ എന്നീ കോളേജുകളുടെ ടീമിനെ ജസ് എത്രയും പെട്ടെന്ന് സ്വാഗത സംഘം ഓഫീസിൽ എത്തിച്ചേരണമെന്നറിയിക്കുന്നു. അർഹാം അസംബ്ലിയുടെ രജിസ്ട്രേഷൻ കൗണ്ടറിന്റെ ഭാഗത്ത് നിൽക്കുന്ന വിദ്യാർത്ഥികൾ അവിടെ നിന്ന് മാറി നിൽക്കണമെന്ന് വളണ്ടിയേഴ്സ് അറിയിക്കുന്നു. വീതി ഒന്നിൽ ഉല വിഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് പ്രസംഗ മത്സരം തുടരുന്നു. നെക്സ്റ്റ് 1111, this is Space Lord Tribhushu. 1111 on the stage. This is Space Lord 1111 on the stage.
അസ്സലാമു അലൈക്കും വറഹ്മത്തുള്ളാഹി തആല വബറകാതുഹു. ബിസ്മില്ലാ വൽഹംദുലില്ലാ അസ്സലാത്തു വസ്സലാമു അലാ റസൂലില്ലാ വഅലാ ആലിഹി അൽഫായിസ് ബിറിദല്ലാ അമ്മാ ബഅദ്. റെസ്പെക്റ്റഡ് ടീച്ചേഴ്സ്, ഡിസ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷ്ഡ് പേഴ്സണാലിറ്റീസ് ഓഫ് ദ ഡേയ്സ് ആൻഡ് മൈ ഡിയർ ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്, ഇറ്റ്സ് എ മൊമെന്റ് ഓഫ് ഹാപ്പി ടു ജോയിൻ വിത്ത് യു ഇൻ ദിസ് കൈൻഡ് ഹോസ്പിറ്റാലിറ്റി ആൻഡ് ആം ഇറിപ്രസിബിൾ ചോയ്സ് ടു ഗെറ്റ് എ മാഗ്നിഫിസന്റ് ചാൻസ് ടു ഷെയർ സം ഐഡിയാസ് അബൌട്ട് ദ സ്റ്റിപ്പുലേറ്റഡ് ടോപ്പിക്, Islamic Brotherhood. Dear brothers in Islam, here you are sitting in front of me, hand in hand and shoulder to shoulder, like one family members, even though you belong to different families and various places. This very sitting in front of me is capable of expressing the real Islamic Brotherhood. What did make this much of unity and solidarity among us? Without any doubt, we can say that the bond of Islam has made us these kinds of brothers and friends. So, the Islamic Brotherhood is a meaningful cooperation and harmony with an aim to encourage what is good and discourage what is evil. The audience, when we look carefully into the literal meaning of brotherhood and its Islamic usage, we can find out that the brotherhood is of three types. A first one, brotherhood, which is based on the blood relationship. A second one, brotherhood existing between all the people on account of their common community. And the third and the last one is the brotherhood on the basis of belief and religious identity. Whatever may be the division, Islam tries to bring the entire people of different states to one platform of brotherhood. That means Islam provides universal brotherhood. Unfortunately, some ignorant and misguided non-Muslims, without going through Holy Quran and prophetic tradition, allege the Islam and argue that Islam is a religion of a narrow thought which excludes those who do not accept Islam. But with the references of Holy Quran and a prophetic tradition, we are bold enough to state that they are flimsy and baseless arguments. Because Almighty Allah says in Holy Quran chapter number 49 and verse number 13, "Oh humankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female and have divided you into nations and tribes so that you shall recognize each other, not despise and fight each other." And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says that لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى يُحِبُّ لِأَخِهِ مَا يُحِبُّ لِنَفْسِهِ. His faith is weak until that person loves for his brother while he loves for himself. Look how Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, directs us to cooperate, help, support each other and to avoid selfishness. Your brothers, besides talking about the universal brotherhood, the uniqueness of Islam is that it practically demonstrates the universal brotherhood. For example, the Muslims are commanded to practice brotherhood 5 times per day in their prayer. It is mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari, the book of Hadith, that when we stood for prayer, the shoulder and foot of the companions have to be attached with each other, irrespective of caste and tribe of his nearer. And we, the Muslims, are proud enough to cite the Hajj as the best example for international brotherhood. That is, during Hajj, about 2.5 million of people from various parts of the world come to Holy Mecca, keeping a single white dress code, whether they are poor or rich, king or people, black or white. You can't identify whether the person standing beside you is a king or not. All are standing alike as the brothers from one family. And it is true that all the people of the whole world living now and that are belonging to one family, that's the family of Adam and Eve, which was mentioned in Holy Quran chapter number 17 and verse number 70. Almighty Allah says that, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Indeed, we have honored the children of Adam and Eve, irrespective of caste, color, tribe and sex. You brothers, the examples of brotherhood make us aware that each of us is a tiny part of a huge society. And if we strive to live Islamically, the society will reach a high level of excellence, justice and brotherhood. Dear brothers, before I conclude my words, let me quote the words of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, which makes you brothers and friends that, Afshu salamu bainakum, spread the greetings of Islam among you. Giving this wonderful message, let me conclude my words. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Radio UN General Vibhagam newspaper making kritim 9:20 തന്നെ ആരംഭിക്കുന്നതാണ്. ഉള്ളിയ വിഭാഗം ഇന്റർവ്യൂ 10:15 വീഡിയോ 6 ആരംഭിക്കുന്നതാണ്. ഇനിയും ഭക്ഷണം സ്വീകരിക്കാൻ ബാധ്യതയുള്ള ടീം മാനേജേഴ്സ് എത്രയും പെട്ടെന്ന് ഭക്ഷണം കഴിപ്പിക്കണമെന്ന് അറിയിക്കുന്നു. ഉന്നയവിഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഇന്റർവ്യൂ 9:15 6 ആരംഭിക്കുന്നതാണ്. ലാസ്റ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഫൈനൽ ടെസ്റ്റ് നമ്പർ 1703. ജസ്റ്റിസ് പ്ലേസ് നോട്ട് 1703 ഓൺ ദി സ്റ്റേജ്.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المخلوقين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. Most respectable teachers, worthy judges, fellow orators and my dear friends, a warm good morning to you all. Lend me your eyes and ears for a short span of time. As all of you know that I am not an eloquent speaker that who can capture the mind and heart of you people in his indefinable vocabularies. I feel selected to stand in front of you to deliver a short speech on the topic Islamic dress code. Friends, Islam is the religion of Allah the Almighty, who discovered the nature, universe, world is a presenter of Islam too. This it is being the adequate lifestyle religion and coding, decoding and coding of without the human. Allah the most praised to be all speaks about the natural melting dress code with a highly spiritual purity of individuality of each human. Similar to Allah, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ سِبْغَةً. See how straight Allah is describing the Islamic dress code. How to be dressed, how not be. There is divinity in dressing. The dress you wear speaks a lot of you. Your mindset, your nature, your traits, your good and bad aspects and much more. Islam suggests wearing a dress that helps a man to grow big to the height of his dignified identity. A man, as a sociology says, not an animal, he's a respected being by Almighty. So he has to keep up with the name Allah that he has given to him. وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. Friends, Islam never speaks upon a particular dress. He should keep his aurat safer and hidden. He should keep and the exterior aurat safer. As Allah told that, culminating keeping the interior aurat safe. When the former, the body is covered the latter, and the soul releases itself to grievances. So Islamic dress code is highly looking to being natural. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, suggested not to join out the dress under the toy. The najas is possible. Have in the dress elongated, once elongated, under the toy. The dress should be clean and tidy. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam suggested again, cleanliness keep the half of the iman. You will never see a religion that gave importance to cleanliness like Islam. A Muslim supposed to be clean always and respect himself. Why should not his dress to be untidy, simple to be a Muslim? If one want to be all, it is a hell and undertaking to be one it. Gerald Tingers raise aside in Islamic or in dress code. Islam draws a marvelously fascinating imaginary or clean dress code, but at the same time, an imaginary, a greatly philosophy of Allah, most speakers of all has been terribly mistook when it is read wrongly. See what Allah says, the most powerful of all, never look at your bodily exterior and peripheral process, but he looks into heart of yours. Thinking Allah is speaking about the bodily style. So many Muslims believe that, they think that he should not wear good clothes with good cost. And wearing rough clothes is sufficient to them. Good clothing, affording houses, nice foods and vehicles, such a worldly facilities to be terrifically against Muslims and Islam. To be honest with you, to be frank with you, it is not to be narrowed. All the facilities of human life is to be enjoyed if it is not halal, or strictly to be avoided if it is not halal. Let us not talk rubbish a lot. You must have noticed that how Bill Clinton visited India. He was fully covered, but his wife fully exposed. Islam muscularly combats such a pseudo feminist thoughts. Let us appreciate human dress code and not animalistic concept in it. Allah forbid that female is to be sought and treated as a sexual toys and male is for enjoy it. Everything Islam is natural, so the Islamic dress code too. Here we are sitting and listening the orations
or Islamic discord. Second after, we will leave from this place and forget everything. Oh friends, Islam is to be practiced, not to preach out. Let me conclude my words. Wa akhir da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
ഇതോടുകൂടെ ഉള്ള വിഭാഗത്തിന്റെ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് പ്രസംഗ മത്സരം ഇവിടെ അവസാനിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നു.